Hello, world. Hello, my beautiful people out there across the board. Hello to my South Africa family that commented on one of my videos. Welcome to everyone to Life with Shay. Welcome, new subscribers. Welcome to the oldies. Welcome to those that are just jumping on here. Welcome to everybody, you guys. Oh my gosh, here comes a burp. Excuse me. It never fails. Hold on, you guys. I don't know if the camera is cut out. Alright, hopefully the camera didn't cut out because I got the notification that I need to put my phone on the charger. But anyway, I am headed. I'm leaving work because I had someone come relieve me for a second while I'm burping. I am headed to go get my omeprazole. Those are the pills that I take for acid reflux. So I am headed now to go get those, which those have been at the pharmacy for like the last past couple of days. So I'm headed to get that. I got a couple errands, you guys, that I have to run today. I am holding my phone and keeping my eyes on the road. Of course, you guys, I am in my seatbelt. So I don't have a stand. For those that say put the phone on the stand, that thing fell off because I had got it from Shein. And when it started to get really, really hot out, the thing just slid down from all the glue that it had on it. It worked for a minute until it started getting really, really hot out. Well, anyway, you guys, enough with all of that chit-chat of nothing that you guys probably want to hear. I am just updating you guys. And also for myself documenting. For those that are just jumping on, I had for the last past, I think, week or two been documenting my pain, my heartbreak from a recent breakup 4 months ago. So get yourself acquainted and caught up on all these videos so that you're not just jumping on this particular video and not know what's going on. Baby girl is looking very pretty, okay? The contour, the highlight, all that is giving today. I think I'm gonna make this probably my last video, you guys, because I don't want to keep really talking about it. I don't know if talking about it is reliving it. Even though it hasn't been a moment that that I've just went all day without thinking about him, I haven't been able to do that yet. So I asked the Lord, and you know they say it's to ask the Lord, be very careful what you ask him or whatever. So I did. I asked him what his will was, and I asked him if he can permanently delete everything about this man and our relationship from my mind. Like, I want to be able to, you know, get the lesson and not just have to keep sitting in this particular memory of knowing that some of my time was given to an individual that wasn't around long term for longevity, that wasn't permanent. And even though they say that some people come into your life for a reason, season, or for a lifetime, I honestly was feeling like in myself that this should have been a lifetime long relationship. Only because, if you guys don't know, I don't even know if I ever mentioned, but he and I grew up on the same street. We grew up together, you know, and I hadn't seen him in so long. So I seen his brother in this place that I was working at, and I asked him about his brother. And this is how he and I end up reconnecting. So it had been 10 years that we hadn't seen each other. So of course, 10 years ago, I mean, he was my crush, you know, he was my crush. And, but he at the time was dating my sister friend, who was much younger than me, about my sister age. And me and my sister's only 2 years apart, so not that much younger or whatever. And I wanted that man when we were younger. But he was the type to be in relationships. He was faithful. No turn on red. I lost my train of thought, you guys. So anyway, yeah. So I'm thinking that was going to be my lifelong partner. Here is a person that I you know, had a crush on back in my childhood days. We're adults now. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, you think that when somebody come back into your life, that it's your person. It's your meant to be. And that was definitely not the case. I guess that wasn't the case. So anyway, to make a long story short, I have been praying. I'm like asking God why. You're not supposed to, they say you don't supposed to question God, but I really feel like if you ask the right questions, you'll get your answers. And God is waiting for us to ask the right questions or whatever. I'm not sitting in this woe is me and Lord, why you do this and why you do that. I want to know, why am I subtly thinking about a person that is not my person? And why can't I just, you know, quickly move on? Okay, quickly move on or whatever. I was like, Lord, okay, I got the lesson. I learned my lesson. Like, what else? I know that you are God that can do anything. You can heal, you can deliver, you can do whatever it is that you choose to want. But why is this thorn yet in my side? Why can't I just move past it and not think about it, at least for one day? Because every day he's been in my thoughts. And I don't care what y'all say, I just kind of wonder if I'm in his thoughts. I want to know that I meant something to somebody, even if it's not us getting back together. Like, everybody want to know that they were loved or something, you know. Not that I'll ever get that answer, and not that I'm gonna sit back trying to throw a pity party if I don't get the answer. No, I'm choosing to move forward. I even denounced that relationship, but then I get these pop-ups on my notifications on YouTube, and it's prophetic, like people prophetically speaking about your ex and how he misses you and how he regrets this and he regrets that. So I'm like, wow, is the universe sending me these messages? Is it the devil? You know, I'm like, is it for my distraction? Like, or is it because this is what the Lord wants me to know? And it's been quite, I don't want to say confusing, because God is not the God of confusion. But there are a lot of people who think that they know God's word. And I swear they feel like they are getting downloads from heaven. I don't know, but I don't know why these things are popping up. So what I do is I take it to the Lord in prayer. You know, some of the things that are popping up, because I'm like, there's no coincidences. Oh, excuse me, you guys. There's no coincidences. So if these messages are popping up, what is it that I need to get from them? You know? So I've been taking things to God in prayer. I did notice that on my way to work. Oh, I got a long day today, you guys, and it's 12:17. But on my way to work, what was I finna say? Oh, I was noticing that I was getting very anxious. Like, Lord, why am I anxious? You know, the Bible says be anxious for nothing, but with everything by prayer and supplication, you make your prayer requests known to God. Because I'm like, Lord, I'm anxious. It's almost like I want to know what's going to happen next. What's the next event in my life? Like, what's next for me concerning a relationship? And I just kind of found myself, you know, rushing through the day, want to rush the day so that things can happen real fast. And I'm glad that I was aware that that's what I was doing. So I prayed to God and like, Lord, take away this anxiousness, because I can identify that this is what is going on. So Lord, please help me. You know, I recognize that my help is not from me. My help is in God or whatever. And yeah, at the end of the day, I want my person. I do. I have not given up on love. I want my person. If it's not him, I want my person. But I want to be very careful about what I'm praying for when it comes to a kingdom relationship, or just a relationship or whatever, because it's something else. You don't know how you gonna encounter what it is that you asking for. You don't know the struggle that will probably come behind it. You don't know how it's going to come about. And for that, it is scary. I don't want to go through anything hectic or chaotic or traumatic, you know, for my person to encounter me. So lately, not every day, but I have been praying for my person. Hopefully he's praying for me. I just want this anxiousness to go away. I want to be able to get through a day without thinking about, oh boy. I made some decisions that I felt like was beneficial for me. Like, you know, blocking his number and just like really falling back from the situation. I even denounced the situation too. Like, I'm like, I denounced this relation, that relationship and everything about it. And then I thought to myself, like, should I have denounced it? But I do believe that what's for me is for me. So I don't need to rush God to do anything. I don't need to rush God to do anything. And with that being said, I just want to be in a place of tranquility, just peace. You know, I just want to be in a state of peace or whatever. So with that, I'm fighting for my peace. I'm fighting for my peace. I'm fighting for my joy. And I just want to overcome and conquer the whole situation. You know, it's not even just him. Like, the fact that, like I said, I just lost my auntie just recently. I wasn't able to really celebrate my birthday for real. My cousin is still in the hospital fighting for her life. It may come to a decision where the family has to make a decision, but she is currently breathing on her own. She had a stroke. The left side of her brain is not that functional. The left side of her brain is not that functional. She can't get a heart transplant because her kidneys are bad. She don't have anybody on the list for a kidney. My auntie was going to do it at one point. I don't know what happened with that. I don't need to put all our family life story out there like that. But, you know, positive prayers for those that, you know, are genuine towards our family at this time, because we can really use positive thoughts and real prayers that, you know, will touch heaven. If you know that you don't have an aught with me, you really, really, really want the best for me, I ask that you would send that prayer out for me, for my cousin, and for my family overall. And just send positive thoughts your way concerning myself and my situation. And until another video, you guys, I'll be putting the comments what you guys want to see next. Again, I don't know if I want to keep jumping on here updating you guys about this situation, or if I even want to just keep documenting it overall. I don't know. I'm saying right now that I don't think that I really want to. But who knows what my day-to-day would be. However, today is a day that the Lord has made. Today is the day that I will rejoice and be glad that I'm still in the land of the living. I still have breath in my body, and God has yet given me another day and another chance. So I need to take advantage of every single opportunity and moment in this day. Today at work, I find myself still a little irritable with people, customers and stuff coming in. Because I'm thinking to myself, like, who needs shoes or whatever you need so early in the morning? Like, get out my store. You know how people be like, don't come to work if you don't want to work. And it's not that. It's just, you know, I'm hurting. So, like I said, hurting people hurt people. And I'm not trying to hurt anybody, but I can tell that I'm still wounded and not happy. Not in a happy place where I want to be because of everything that is going on in my life. So that. So, bye, you guys. Subscribe if you're not a subscriber. Thumbs up. And I'll see you guys next on another video. Comment down below again what you want to see next. And I'll try to make that happen. All right. Deuces.